Hello, MS here. Today we're going to implement hardware abstraction layer. I will show you how to do it and how I did it in Yasboot. So, what is the hardware abstraction layer? Basically, it's a level of software that allows me to easily add new hardwares to be supported by my project. And how I'm going to realize it. So, firstly, I want to create interface packages, like for UART. This package will contain only header files with interfaces that my project will be using. For example, for UART at the beginning, we have methods to set baud rate, to write some data, and that's all. And after that, each specific hardware will implement those functions inside their own source files. And you may be interested why I have so long path here, like hardware abstraction layer, interface, include, once again, hardware abstraction layer. And I'm doing that because this is quite nice solution to C++ compiler, because since the path is very strange, I can add it as my include directory. So I will trim path until include. So in source files, I will use normal include hal/uart-hpp. But since path is quite strange, I have to link to that library in CMake, otherwise I won't be able to access that files. And this gives me a compile time check that I propagated my dependencies correctly. My hardware abstraction layer will be configurable via KConfig, so I have to add new files for new board, and this new board will be host. And what does mean this host hardware? Is it really existing one? So the answer is yes and no. It's existing because it's my normal PC computer, but it can be any computer that we can compile that code and execute. Why I'm creating that? Because I want to make Yasboot testable on my development PC. It will be much faster to test our logic that we are trying to introduce on the same machine that I am programming. And it also allows me to write some tests for that. As you were able to see, new board was visible in menu config, but I wasn't sure how to add dependency in KConfig scripts, so I asked Bing AI. It's failing day. Tu-tu-tu-tu, it's failing day. Tu-tu-tu, it's failing day. Tu-tu-tu-tu, it's failing day. Firstly, I was fighting with errors from KConfig. And after that, as you can see on the video, when errors disappeared, I had another issue. So when I select one value, the dependent values are not updated. So if I change board from MSPC to host, there are no changes in CPU or CPU family. To find an issue, I reduced complexity of my KConfig script, so I've replaced almost each configuration with simplified one. To have only one choice that will update another choice. I've used Bing AI, I've used Google, and there were no answers how to fix that issue. Pause. Wait a second. Do you see that? Why I haven't read that issue before? It was here from beginning. So instead of blindly asking Google and Bing AI how to reach my goal, I should just ask how to pass dependency to choice. And of course, firstly, I've tried the solution with simplified KConfig that I prepared during fighting with failure. And yeah, it's working now. So let's port it to the full KConfig tree. So the solution was quite simple. In KConfig lib, you can use if statement. So if board host is defined, then select default value in choice of, for example, CPU. And it will propagate. If some CPU is selected, then select default value for CPU architecture. And exactly same for CPU family. Of course, I also ported MSPC because I want to support both from today. while implementing this, I decided to choose some standard how I will name my variables and choices inside KConfig, because it may be misleading otherwise. So the choice will always have suffix choice, and for config options there will follow, like, for example, CPU, then name host or RP2040. And in the meantime, I rename KConfig files from name.kconfig to just KConfig. And thanks to that, I fix syntax highlighting in my editor. When KConfig is working, it's time to start creating a library for HAL implementation for host architecture. It's quite normal CMake job to do. Adding library, adding target sources, adding library with HAL interfaces. That's important step, because previously I showed to you that I'm using that kind of strange directories to include. So if I want add it here, then I won't be able to include header files from HAL. Because of my project structure, I have to create MCU init CMake file, and this file must be inside CMake module path. So I created one, and this file has to contain two functions. One is pre-initialize CPU, and in that function we have to provide things that must be done before actual CMake generator is called, so before we start the project in CMake. And initialize CPU does things after project call in CMake, so when we have configured project and we want to add our board CMakes. Then it's time to provide our board library, and this board library, for now it will only forward host implementation, and that's all, nothing more. And every board defines exactly same library with exactly same name. So after that, Yasboot project includes only board, and this board contains actual board implementation, for example for host or for MSPC or for Raspberry Pico. So after that, Yasboot project includes only board, and this board contains actual board implementation, for example for host. Then let's add UART implementation. For host it uses IO streams, and since I'm using templates implementation inside CPP files, and I'm doing that because I know exactly what boards are supported and what hardware can be used. And it works, but new lines are strange, so let's fix them. And now we have working HAL. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and let me know in comments what you think about the new form. Oh, if you haven't seen already a newsletter and Q&A, somewhere there is link.